So Man City versus Arsenal match review. Some people call it a snooze fest, and I do agree to a certain extent. Tactically, it was still a very interesting game, but that's the reason why it was so boring. If it's tactically so interesting, it means the entertainment aspect has taken a hit, and that's what we saw. We saw Professor Guardiola against student Arteta. Arteta happy with the 0-0 draw, and Arsenal, big credit to Arsenal. Whatever you say, Arsenal came with a game plan and they succeeded. And Man City on paper were in their 4-2-3-1, but in settled phases of play, which means when Man City were pushing Arsenal deep into their half, Arsenal going in their 4-4-2 like this, very compact, and Man City's last defender was here and everyone else was there. That's what I mean by settled moments of play. Settled phases of possession means when the ball just keeps circulating back, the final defender is here, the goalkeeper is around there, and that's how you really dominate teams. And that's essentially what we saw from Man City. And in settled phases of play, obviously Haaland occupied this area here. Foden occupied this area. De Bruyne occupied this area. Bernardo Silva was out wide. Who filled up the left wing spot? It was Guardiola. Guardiola went all the way there. Now Rodri went over to left centre mid because Akanji came inside. Where did Kovacic go? Kovacic ended up there with Ake and Diaz like that. This is essentially what we saw from Man City. That was their shape. The 3-2-5, but in a way that I don't think I've seen before, with the centre midfielder dropping in to left centre back to be able to get on the ball and really dictate play. Akanji got injured and then Rico Lewis came on, but Rico Lewis really likes this role as well. So with that substitution, tactically, Man City did not change because Rico Lewis is very, very competent operating in that extra pivot role coming in from right back. So notice how that 4-2-3-1, that's Man City. Their 4-2-3-1 suddenly shifts into a 3-2-5 by courtesy of the left back becoming the left winger and the left centre mid becoming the left centre back. The right back inverting here and the right winger staying where he is, which was Bernardo Silva. And sometimes Bernardo Silva would come inside and Akanji would stay out wide. So they had that relationship as well. And I just think, yes, it was a boring game and everything, but tactically, I think that's very interesting. And yes, the overall game was boring and Man City did not score, but that sort of rotation is so good to watch. From my point of view, I love it. I love to see a centre midfielder going in an unorthodox position, getting on the ball and making things happen. Because essentially that's what Guardiola wanted. So Guardiola thought, okay, let me get my right-footed ball retainer in the left area. Because now, when the ball gets circulated, someone like Kovacic, who can really run with the ball as well and keep it, he controls it with his left foot, then he can drive with his right foot and then play to Guardiola. But if it was Guardiola here, Guardiola is only left-footed. So he would only go there. But with Kovacic, with his right foot, he could play there and he can play inside. Kovacic could look this way and play that way, like those little reverse balls. Now, I'm not saying Kovacic did that amazingly. I'm just saying it could be any team. It could be any centre midfielder. Frenkie de Jong, Barcelona 2022, when Xavi first took over, Dani Alves inverted like that next to Busquets, and Frenkie de Jong dropped in there. And then it was Pedri, Gavi, Dani Alves and Busquets. And Frenkie de Jong ended up there because Frenkie de Jong, once again, he's very good at running with the ball. He can keep it as well. And then he's good at dictating the game from deeper areas. And if you really want to push the opposition back and really have sustained periods of possession, that's what you should do. Just like Inter Milan, Inzaghi pushes Barella, Mkhitaryan, Calhanoglu all the way to the back line and pushes the defenders up into midfield. And they keep the ball more comfortably. So that's something to really think about. And I'm personally a huge advocate of that. Just to see my centre midfielder, who can keep the ball a lot, drop there, rotate it around, create some confusion amongst the opposition, because I can guarantee you Arsenal did not expect Kovacic to drop in that area. They did not. Now, with regards to Arsenal, their compact 4-4-2 shape was a defensive masterclass. Yes, Arteta proved to everyone that he could play the modern possession attacking style of football, but he can also show how to keep a clean sheet at the Etihad with like 25% ball possession and you want to win the league. Wow. Gabriel Saliba, unbelievable performance, just like Ben White as well. Jorginho Rice, very disciplined in there. Odegaard and Havertz worked in tandem to make sure nothing went through. But in the first 10-15 minutes, Kovacic did have some joy in this area. Operating in this area, getting the ball, playing out wide, getting it again. Little intricate play with Foden, Rodri, De Bruyne roaming there as well. So it took Arsenal a bit of time to figure it out. And essentially, figuring it out meant just staying even more compact. Not getting drawn out to Kovacic, doing those little intricate one-twos, those little passes. No. Just staying where you are, letting the ball come in this area, and that's when Arsenal were very, very aggressive with the way they pressed. If you look at Arsenal's density, this is not a physics lesson, this is not a chemistry lesson, it's not a biology lesson either. Density, look how dense they are. Look, that's the density that Arsenal have today. Literally, Odegaard, Havertz, Saka, Jesus, Jorginho, Rice, and in the back four. If you look at other teams who are struggling defensively at the moment, such as this team right here, they are not dense. What does that mean? You have the attackers here, the wingers there, the midfielders like this, and then there are gaps in between. But the denser you are, the less space there is for the opposition. So, density, just like this. How many times did we see Foden and De Bruyne get the ball in the pocket? I don't think I saw that. I really don't think they got the ball on the half turn and were able to play. They didn't. Yes, Foden and De Bruyne are still in space, but if the ball was to go in there, because they're so compact and dense, Saka's foot and Rice's foot or Jorginho's foot will be in the way. They'll just do a slide tackle or they'll just nick it and do a counter-attack. And then Man City would be forcing the pass. That's literally what it means. So by staying compact like this, that pass is never on. Even though it looks like it's on, it's not. So Foden and De Bruyne will be operating in a pocket, but they'll just not be getting the ball because of how dense they are, because of the distances. Reducing the distances. So overall, it was an absolute defensive masterclass from Mikel Arteta. Now, what they did was they let the ball go out wide. Very basic defensive 101. Ben White would press the ball aggressively. Saliba, Gabriel, Kiwi would shuffle across. And then Jesus would become a temporary left back. So they would have a back five shifted across like this. And then Jorginho, Rice, Saka, Odegaard and Havertz would be like that. So all Man City could do, irrespective of whether or not Foden made those forward runs like this and dragged him out and then De Bruyne came in, irrespective of all of those movements that they did, Man City had to go back. And when they went back, they quickly went back into their shape like this and regrouped in their dense shape. And then Man City went like this, 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 like this. Back here, press, move across, Saka, right back. That's all they did. And then in the final few minutes of the game, in the last 5 minutes, Arsenal went into a 6-2-2 formation. That's Ben White, Gabriel, Saliba, Tomiyasu, Gabriel, Saliba, Ben White, and Saka on that side. That was how they went. They went into a 6-2-2, literally like this, or a 6-3-1. So their wingers came back, the fullbacks went inside, so they basically had four centre-backs within the width of the penalty box, with the wingers occupying just that bit on the outside. And I mean, talk about density, talk about defensive compactness, talk about defensive rigidity. That's what Arsenal showed today. So big, big credit to Arsenal. I think they could have got a goal at the end. There was a moment where Trossard had the ball here. All he had to do was just outside of the foot, across goal, and Saka would have scored. But he took an extra touch, and then he took a shot, and then it went out for a corner. So Arsenal nearly nicked it. So big credit to Arsenal once again. Could Man City have done better? I think they could have. It's just that simple paradigm in modern football, breaking down low blocks. How do you go about doing it? It's a big ask, isn't it? It's a big ask to break down such a compact low block. But once again, it can come down to individual brilliance. Did Foden have a good game? Did De Bruyne have a good game? Haaland, Silva, did they have a good game? No, they didn't. And that's what it comes down to. Against a low block, if you have a player like Messi, who's a magician, he'll make things happen, that low block becomes ineffective because you can never anticipate what someone will do individually. You can't read their mind. So someone like Messi will just drop deep and get the ball, play a ball over the top, and they'll score an assist. Or he'll just get the ball and just run at the defence. A very underrated way of breaking down low blocks is by running at the defence. If you're good enough to drive and run with the ball, players will get drawn to you. That means they've left their space. That means that we can play in triple combinations, then we can score. So Man City, individually, were not at their greatest. Therefore, they could not break down the low block. They couldn't get any luck from the corners or a little penalty or shot off the edge of the box. So 0-0 was a very fair result. The title race, whose is it? Is it Liverpool's? Is it Man City's? Is it Arsenal's? We don't know. It's too early to tell. And once again, yes, it was a boring game from an entertainment point of view, but tactically, there was a lot of information to be gained. And I hope you gained that information from this video. If you did, please drop a like. Comment, share, subscribe, do all of that stuff if you like. If you don't, no worries. I'm glad that you still took the insight anyway. So until next time, stay peaceful, stay blessed. It's the Honest Football Coach, Coach Rafaz, by the way. Peace.